Good morning, my dear. I have come with a new unit, that is self-management skill. In this, I will cover three parts: motivation and positive attitude. Next, result orientation. Next, self-awareness. Students, first of all, you have to know what is self-management. Self-management, which is also referred to as a self-control, is the ability to control one's emotion, thoughts, and behavior effectively in different situations. This includes motivating oneself and working towards achieving personal and academic goals. Students with strong self-management skills are better at doing certain things well, such as coming to the class on time, paying attention, obeying teachers, parents, and elders, as well as working with discipline. It helps a person to do better in studies or work. To manage oneself well, a person needs to develop the following things. What are? First one is the positive thinking. To think about one Now the next one First one is positive thinking. To think that one can get things done and be happy. Next, result orientation. To dream big and achieve the desired or set results. And the last one, self-awareness, to be aware of one's personality traits and make the best out of one's strengths. This all I will discuss later on in details. Now, the first one is motivation. Students, motivation is defined as the drive required to engage in goal-oriented behavior. Motivation is inner urge to do something, and self-motivation is ability to do what need to be done without the influence or thrust from other people or situation. Okay, self-motivated individuals are assets to the world, their country, their families, and to themselves. Self-motivated individual practice righteousness. They do what is required to accomplish their goal. Self-motivated people have elevated spirit and are full of positivity and energetic, you can say. For them, nothing is impossible. They are focused on their goals and objectives and, yes, diligently achieve their aims. So if I'm talking about the self-motivation, then why the self-motivation is important? You must have to know it. See, already, yes, some points are, yes, written on the screen. First one, it increases individual's energy and activity. Next, it directs an individual towards specific goals. It results in initiation and persistence of specific activities. It affects cognitive processes and learning strategies used for completing a similar tasks. Students, an individual's motivation may come from within or be inspired by others or event. So if I say yes about the motivation, individual's motivation, then it can be divided in two parts. One is intrinsic motivation and other one is extrinsic motivation. So what is intrinsic motivation? It includes activities for which there is no apparent reward, but one derives employment and satisfaction in doing them. It occurs when people are internally motivated to do something because it brings them pleasures. Next one, extrinsic. Yes, motivation. It arises because of incentives or external rewards. Lack of motivation or incentives may lead to frustration. Yes, I can give one example by which you can understand. Like employees who are kept on contractual basis for a long time may get frustrated and leave an organization. Okay. Now, next one is your positive attitude. A positive attitude makes a person happier and help build and maintain relationship. It even increases one's chances of success. In addition, it can help the person make better, yes, decision. Students, people who maintain a positive attitude in life situations and challenges are able to move forward than those with a negative attitude. Students, positive attitude helps improve mental and physical health. Yes, there are different ways, yes, to maintain positive attitude. It can take a little time and effort to build a positive attitude. So you can see, yes, there are different ways that can help one maintain a positive attitude. First one, start the day with a morning routine, my dear. Say positive affirmations, smile often, and think about the task, yes, to be accomplished during for the day. Next, feed the mind with positivity. Read motivating books. Okay, listen to music with uplifting lyrics. Watch inspiring movies. Yes, education channel. Next one is be proactive. Okay, a proactive person decides how one must feel regardless of what may be going around or what the day may bring. Next one, focus on constructive and positive things. Do not approach life with the problems. Approach it with the solutions. Next, learn from failures, think what could have been matter and work towards the goals. Next, learn to focus on the present. Negativity mostly stems out from anxiety of the past and future events. And the last one, move towards your goals and dreams. Be cheerful and work hard to achieve the dream. Students, here are some techniques that can help you to maintain a positive outlook in long run. First one is physical exercise and fresh air. For a healthy lifestyle, it is essential for students practicing yoga, meditation and deep breathing exercise help improve blood circulation and relax your body. Taking a walk or playing in the park helps one to get a lot of fresh air, which helps in becoming more active. Next, healthy diet. A healthy and balanced diet is important for a healthy body and mind. Eating a balanced diet such as roti, green vegetables, dal, fruits, provides the strength required to do daily work efficiently. Next, organize academic life. By keeping class notes organized, completing assignment on time, watching the videos on time, and keeping tracks of all deadlines, stress can be reduced to a great extent. So when you are going, or when you think, or when you are not stressed, you can channelize your mind to achieve the goal. Next one is adequate sleep. A good night's sleep for at least 8 or 9 hours is important so that the mind and body can get relaxed and recharged to function better the next day, my dear. Next, holidays with family and friends. Visiting a relative's place, it can be your maternal uncle's home, grandparents' home, or maybe your friend's home, or a new place during summer vacation can help one break the monotonous normal routine and come back refreshed. Students, positive attitude is of immense values in a student's life. There are various situations that students will encounter in life wherein staying positive will help the child going. Will help the child, going. The most common example would be during exam result. At times, a student does not get the desired result in exam, but it is important not to lose hope, lose confidence, accept the result gracefully and work harder with a positive attitude for next exam. Even during an interview for a dream job, a candidate may not get selected in the first attempt. Whatever the drawbacks were, whatever the shortcomings were, that must be sorted, that must be solved. Okay? Yes, with a positive attitude, yes, all dreams can be achieved, my dear. So it becomes imperative for a child to learn to practice positive attitude in life at all times. Now, the next part, that is, what is stress and how to manage it? See, stress is a state of feeling upset, annoyed, and hopeless. There are times when we feel nothing is working right. We are not able to achieve our goal and feel hopeless. During such times, if we manage and control our emotions, it helps us to sail through. Some of the ways to manage stress are, first, stay positive and analyze what is going wrong in a certain situation. Second, maintain an achievement seat and enter even small achievements. Next, keep your thoughts in present. Next, talk to your friends and families for comfort. Practice meditation. Whenever you feel negative thoughts are taking over, take a look at your accomplishment sheet. Now, the next part is result orientation. Result orientation is a term used to describe a personal ability to recognize what results are important and the steps needed to be taken to achieve them. It means to focus on the result of an assigned task. If you know the result you want to achieve, you can focus on the efforts required to achieve it. Hence, result orientation describes an individual or organization that focuses on outcome rather than the process that has been used to produce a product or deliver a service. Students, an ideal employees need to be proactive and result driven. The person must always take necessary steps, yes, to achieve the set goals, or you can say target. So how to become, yes, result oriented? Now, first one is set clear goals. Setting clear and accurate goals is the first step one needs to take to meet the target. Second, prepare an active plan. Yes, an action plan describes the way a person or an organization will meet to set the objectives. It gives a details of the steps to be taken to achieve the target. Okay. Therefore, it consists of several actions or steps that need to be taken and changes that need to be made. Each action step or change should include the following information. First, what changes will occur after the action? Who will carry out the changes? When will the changes take place? And how long will the changes stay? Okay, what should know about, or you can say in other way, what should know and what should be, yes, communicated. Okay, next one, use the right resources and tools. One must evaluate the resources and tools needed to achieve those results and whether they are available. For example, you may want to clear the college entrance exam, yes, with 90% marks. Do you have the book to study for the exam? If not, from where and how can you get them? Okay, so this is the main part. Next one, communicate with mentors and peers. One must talk to teachers, elders, seniors, and mentors to help in setting goals. Next, make a calendar. One must make a calendar to monitor the progress at regular intervals. Next, work hard. One must work hard and believes in one's dreams. Now, the next one is goal setting. Goal setting helps us to understand what we want and how to achieve it, and how do we measure our success. Students, writing a goal requires that we should understand, yes, its purpose and objective. Now, next part that comes, how to define a goal. Okay, so identify what the goal is about. For example, customer satisfaction, okay, delivering process, whatever you can say it, my dear. Next, how the goal would make a difference. For example, will it enhance customer satisfaction? Will it result in an increase in demand of a product or service? Speed up the delivery process and result in better loyalty and quality of the product. Okay, now students, see what are the acronyms SMART has to deal goals. First one is specific, next one is measurable, next one action oriented, next realistic, and the last one timely. So first one is specific. Goals should be stated in specific terms. Goals are difficult to attain. Specific goals give us a concrete target. So a goal should have a specific purpose. Next one is measurable. Okay, goals should be measurable. If we do not set our goals in measurable time, it is difficult to assess whether we have achieved them or not. Next one is action oriented. Goal do not just come, yes, true on their own. Effective goal setting should include action based steps that one will follow to achieve the goal. What action that I am already taking towards achieving this goal? Next, action that I am currently just talking but will take towards achieving the goals. Next, actions that I am not currently taking and need help to achieve the goal. Next, people and places from whom I can get help to achieve the goal. Okay. Next one is realistic. There are few things. Okay. More damaging to our sense of self-efficacy than setting ourselves, yes, up for failure. Goal must always be realistic. Next one is timely. Okay, goal must have its deadlines. Deadlines may change, but one must set a deadline to get the job, yes, done within a specific time limit. Examples of result-oriented goals can be: a student may set a goal of achieving high marks in the exam. A traveler may try to reach a destination city, yes, within certain time. It can be an athlete may run 5 miles a day. Okay. Now, the next one is self-awareness. Self-awareness is about understanding one's own needs, desired habits, traits, behavior, and feelings. When we are not aware of ourselves, then we trade in a direction about which we are not clear. Okay, therefore it is important that we must be aware of ourselves. So what are the steps towards self-awareness? The first step for practicing self-awareness is gaining a greater awareness of one's emotion. The second step is to practicing self-awareness is making a habit of tracking one's feeling. The third step for practicing self-awareness in expanding one's practice to area of life beyond the person's feeling. You can see various emotion a person experiences. You can see here good, happy, scared. Just by his or her expression you can understand it. Sad, sick. Okay. Now the next part is personality and personality traits. Okay, personality is a culture of thoughts, feelings, and behaviors that make a person unique and different from others. Personality traits are defined as relatively lasting pattern of thoughts, feelings, and behaviors that distinguish individuals from one another. Hence, personality development is the development of an organized pattern of behaviors and attitudes that makes a person distinctive. Personality development occurs by the ongoing interaction of, yes, temperament, character, and environment. Culture also plays an important role in shaping personalities. One's personality also affects the person's relationships with others. A positive personality can lead to better performance, increased productivity, and cordial relationship with others. Students, there are 5 parameters that describes and individual personality. These five dimensions are also called big five factors. Okay, and the model is referred as the five factors model, which is abbreviated as FFM. Now, common personality disorders. Personality disorders involves long-term patterns, thoughts, and behavior that are unhealthy and rigid. A personality disorder is a way of thinking, feeling, and behaving that deviates from worldly expectation and causes distress which lasts over time. Now, there are three cultures. First one is suspicious. People falling under this culture always mistrust other and are suspicious even when there is no need to do. Now you can take an example. Raju is a home worker. Okay. He has been working in anyone house for 2 years. Now, despite having CCTV cameras installed at home, Raju is always suspicious about the maid. Now you can take example. Varsha is a homemaker. A maid has been working at her house for 2 years. Despite having CCTV cameras installed at home, Varsha is always suspicious about the maid. She follows her all the time and keeps a tab on her movement. This causes stress between Varsha and her maid. Now, the next one is cluster B, emotional and impulsive. This personality disorder is characterized by unstable moods and behavior, which leads to unhealthy and unstable relationship, emotional instability, and feelings of worthiness. For example, Sunny is a student in high school. Whenever he gets low marks, he is depressed and fights with his friends. He also does not try to learn from mistakes. His parents and teachers have tried talking with him, but he feels angry, worthless, and shouts at them. Next one is cluster C. Anxious. Now, the next one is anxious. This personality disorder is characterized by feelings of worry, anxiety, or fear, which have the potential to affect one's daily routine. Like, I'm giving one example. Sikha is an elderly woman. She stays with her family. She has a habit of washing her hands at least 20 minutes a day. Even after washing her hands, she feels that they are not clean properly and continues rubbing or washing them. She neither talks to her grandchildren, nor does he participate in any family activity. Now, the next one is, what are the steps to overcome personality disorders? First one, talk to someone. Most often it helps to share your feelings. Next, look after your physical health. A healthy body can help you maintain a healthy mind. Next, build confidence in your ability to handle difficult situations. See, in the adverse situation, you yourself, yes, have to overcome from such a situation. Next, engage in hobbies such as music, dance, and painting. These have a therapeutic effect. Now, you know, music, dance, and painting, whatever you have stress, you have disorder, okay, that this all can be removed only by certain things. Stay positive by choosing words like challenges instead of problem. Whatever the situation comes, never say this is the problem. How to tackle such situation? Yes, that spirit must be with you. So these are the very important points, yes, to overcome personality disorder. I hope you all have understood these all topics. Thank you, my dear.